Talking about text, if you really want to reduce the number of file requests your page makes, you can inline images using code. Two ways to do that, SVG and data URIs. Now, here's a vector graphic you may have seen before. Both versions look identical, and here they are in emulation mode, and here on a real phone. Looking at the page source, you'll see that the logos are declared inline. There's an SVG, and an image element with a data URI source. Inline SVG has great support on mobile and desktop browsers. And optimization tools can significantly reduce SVG size. Spot the difference. These two inline SVG logos look identical, but one is around 3 kilobytes and the other only about 2K. SVG is incredibly powerful. Check out this interactive version of Trajan's column. Works on mobile too. And the best thing, all that responsive interactivity for less than 160 kilobytes. For more amazing SVG examples, check out the link below the video. Data URIs provide a way to include a file, such as an image, inline as a base64 encoded string using the following format. The full version is around 5,000 characters. Just like SVG, data URIs are well supported on mobile and desktop browsers. That's around, well, nearly 97% of browsers. So, you can inline images in your HTML, but data URIs and SVGs can also be inlined in CSS. Works on desktop and on mobile. Here we have two identical looking images implemented as background images in CSS. One data URI and one SVG. Now, the code looks a bit crazy, so why would you want to do this? Well, to reduce HTTP requests.